Looks like the reinvention of the shotgun microphone is really happening. In my production, I'm using various different type of microphones, like an overhead shotgun microphone, XLR bigger production microphones, lavalier microphones, and over on top the camera microphones for vlogging and other similar stuff. Maybe there is an all-in-one solution for my studio recording right here. Comica developed an all-in-one transformable shotgun called the Trex Shot. It gives you the ability to record a tight audio source and 30 degree audio source and 90 degree stereo audio source and record simultaneously back and forth, flipping your audio recording modes in different ways. This is kind of my first multi-purpose shotgun microphones in my hands. In the first link in the description, you can get straight to the buying site of the Trex Shot Comica microphone, and under it you can find my other microphone reviews. And if you're interested, they should be really useful and actually get you an idea what I'm using in my studio and commercial production. Let's get firstly to an unboxing and then a deeper understanding on how this Trex Shot microphone works. The packaging is really well presented with a harder softshell case. You'll get a Trex Shot microphone in all its beauty and glory. Double windscreens, 3.5 TRS-TRS cable, 3.5 TRS-TRRS cable, charging USB-C cable, great logical user manual and warranty card. Let's get a physical look on the Trex Shot microphones with some specs. The Trex Shot is made with two microphone capsules switchable in four different pickup modes. Mono mode for a tight pickup, 30 degree stereo mode for a little wider pickup angle, 90 degree stereo mode and a bidirectional mode, so you can record yourself and another person in front of you, let's say a vlogging scenario. So you can actually record yourself with a microphone pointing straight to your mouth and another person recorded straight with the microphone pointing on that person. You will be presented by a big bright OLED screen with some basic info. Mode button for the mode selector. A low cut power button with dedicated sign. On the top of the microphone unit you will find the gain control knob from 0 to plus 10. On the right side you will find headphones monitor out, and on the left side the line out for your camera or smartphone. There is also a USB-C charging upgrade port near it. Under it, there is also the so-called AirFloat shock absorption design hot shoe mount with threaded 1/4 shoe mount under it. The included high-density double muffs will get you sure that you record better audio quality recordings in windy conditions, filtering the high-level wind noise. Basically, that's kind of it, and simple yet sophisticated recording shotgun all-in-one microphone. I will be using it right now for some test audio shots, recording straight to my Sony a7 III in my not-so-soundproof kitchen studio setup, so you can hear the actual audio quality, and actually I will be switching back and forth, also recording with my Tuckstar SCG microphone that I'm using all the time for all my videos. Test, test, 1, 2, 3. Now we are hearing the voice straight from the Tuckstar microphone that I'm using every day, all the time on my YouTube studio recording, straight to my Sony a7 S3 with the Zeiss 55 on it. Test, test, 1, 2, 3. Now recording straight to the Comica Trex Shot microphone in the tightest setting in mono mode, connected straight to my Sony a7 S3 with the Zeiss 55 mounted on top. Now I'm recording back into the tightest mode with the low cut filter on, so you can understand the difference and how it sounds in this mode connected straight to my Sony a7 S3 filmed with the Zeiss 55. Test, test, 1, 2, 3. Now I'm recording straight to the Comica Trex Shot microphone in the 30 degree angle stereo S1 mode using the Sony a7 S3 with the Zeiss 55, so you can understand how it sounds and the sound difference. Test, test, 1, 2, 3. I'm recording straight to Comica 90 degree stereo S2 mode, so you can understand the difference and how it sounds in this not so soundy studio environment on my Sony a7 S3 with the Zeiss 55. Test, test, 1, 2, 3. Now I'm recording straight with the microphone facing the other side and one facing me, so you can understand how it sounds in this sound recording environment with the Sony a7 S3 and the Zeiss 55 mounted on top. Test, test, 1-2-3, now I'm recording straight on the Comica Trackshot microphone connected to my Sony A7 S3 with the Zeiss 55 on the tightest mode with mono mode settings, and you can hear the audio and how it sounds. Let's go and switch it to the 30 degree angle stereo mode. Test, test, 1-2-3. Now I'm recording straight with the V-shaped 30 degree stereo audio mode connected straight to my Sony A7 III, and you can hear the audio and how it sounds in this not so soundproof studio kitchen environment. Test, test, 1-2-3. Now I'm recording straight to the V-shaped 90 degree angle S2 stereo mode connected straight to my Sony A7 S3 with the Zeiss 55, and you can hear actually the difference and the sound that it's picking up while I'm talking. Test, test, 1-2-3. Now I'm recording straight into the Comica microphone with the flipped option, one microphone pointing straight to my mouth and the other on the other side for an additional recording scene, just like an interview or run and gun situation. And you can hear the actual sound picked up by the front microphone. Let's get straight to my opinions and should you get one or should you skip it for your next shotgun microphone. Firstly, I like the concept of having a multi-purpose, different pickup microphone ready to go, no bigger than the microphones that I already use. The big OLED screen gives me all the basic info about the modes, but I would have loved to see the actual gain monitoring pickup lines inside the actual screen and getting a better reference for the visual understanding of the audio levels. Maybe in a future update they will add it. I will also like to have the modes switched automatically when putting the microphones in their respective four ways of recording. Now you have to physically switch the button for the direction intended when recording. These are just some small things that caught my eye. Rather than that, I'm pretty sure that this microphone can find a wide array of using scenarios and recording. I will be adding it to my collection and maybe I will start using it as my overhead shotgun microphone. If you have any question, feel free to comment down below, I will be happy to answer to all of them. Until my next one, thumbs up if you liked it, subscribe with the bell icon so you get notified every time I make a new video, and see you on my next one.